Hey guys, it's Jonathan. We're just going to talk about how to simplify the market through technical analysis. We don't want lots of lines. We don't want confusing charts. We don't want tons of support and resistance. We talked about Monday, our line in the sand, right? Our line in the sand is just going to be this 200 period moving average on a daily chart. Let's get a little bit more data on here. Why is that our line in the sand? Why are we bearish underneath and bullish over? Well, if you go back and look at past data, you can see the S&P futures do not like to stay around this major number. We can see it, clear as day. So that's really the only reason why that becomes our main line in the sand. Yesterday, we put out the Premier Member Alert, talked about where the support was going to be. Support, last week's low. Last week's low, 28.17. This level right here, 27.12. 27.17, pardon me, 27.12. And then yesterday's low, 27.14. We closed at 27. Right now, before the opening, we're about 38. So keeping things really simple, an overall market view. Right now, 27.39, support is going to be 27.17, 27.15, that kind of band down here, which is going to be the low of yesterday and this low. And then resistance is going to be 27.63, that same line in the sand. Keep it super, super simple. If we get above this level, volatility is going to come out of the market in a very big way. Also, think about the calendar. Think about the calendar means next week is Thanksgiving week. Thanksgiving, the market's open, but it really feels like it's closed. It's so freaking slow. So what happens is the market's probably going to slowly grind higher because volatility is going to come out of the market. When volatility comes out of the market, overall equities are going to trade higher. That's how it works. There's no trouble to the upside. When the market rallies, everything's rosy. No volatility. When the market goes down, there's massive uncertainty, so the VIX skyrockets. Keep things simple. We know the range. Let the market show us which way it wants to go. Let's move over to POS. POS, silver company. Silver right now is obnoxiously inexpensive relative to gold. If I put on gold futures, and then if I put on our gold relative to silver, this is just a proprietary indicator we built. It's super simplistic though. It's just gold divided by silver. Add selected, apply, okay. All this is doing is showing us gold relative to silver. So when it's trading up high, 86, that means that silver is very inexpensive to gold. So if we want to be long one of the metals, we want to be long silver, we don't want to be long gold. This is like at a 100-year high. This ratio has stayed between 15 and 90 for the last 100 years. We've been following this story for a couple of weeks, but one of our Apex members, our coaching client members, shared this article, Zero Hedge catching up as well, gold relative to silver at the highest it's been for a very, very long time. So for the Premier members, guys, I'll attach this article. I really like you to read it. This is something that we follow closely all the time. You can see it's kind of a mean reverting trade. It averages maybe 40 or 50. Right now it's at 85. Again, if you want to be long gold or silver, up here you want to be long silver. If you want to be short gold or silver, you don't want to be short silver, you'd rather be short gold. You'll find over time it's a very, very useful indicator to follow. My favorite way to express an opinion getting long silver is getting long PAAS. It closed at 14.13. It looks like it's going to open like at $12.50 or $12.20. I like buying POS on the opening today. It looks like last trade is like $12.56. Okay? Remember, guys, keep it simple. I find that technical analysis, technicians, everybody makes it so complicated. Everybody wants to show how smart they are. Keep things simplistic. The more simple you can make your trading, the better off they're going to be in the long term. Hope it helps. Jonathan Rose, Active Day Trader.